Chairman Meeks, Representative McCall, and distinguished members of the committee, thank you for the opportunity to be with you and my friends on this panel. I focused my statement for the record on describing the causes of our self-defeat in Afghanistan based on strategic narcissism and self-delusion. But I hope that we might also discuss the likely long-term consequences associated with the catastrophe there and what we might do to mitigate those consequences and begin to recover. The humanitarian, security, and political disasters in Afghanistan are just beginning. The Taliban are reimposing brutal Sharia. More Afghans will suffer. The numbers of refugees will grow. The ready-made hostage crisis that resulted from leaving American and allied citizens behind, as well as those Afghans who fought to preserve their freedom, will continue. Jihadist terrorists are gaining psychological, financial, and physical strength. A victory for the Taliban is a victory for jihadist terrorists everywhere, but especially for those based in South and Central Asia. The Haqqani Network and Al-Qaeda are completely intertwined with the Taliban. They and other terrorist organizations are celebrating a jihadist victory over the world's superpower. They're using our surrender and withdraw, as ISIS used the establishment of the Islamic State in 2014 after our complete withdrawal from Iraq in December 2011, to recruit more to the cause from far beyond their emirate in Afghanistan. The Islamic Emirate of Afghanistan will give jihadists unfettered access to the lucrative narcotics trade, other illicit enterprises, state revenue, and diverted international assistance. But the jihadist terrorist organizations are not only growing larger in numbers, more confident and richer, they are also becoming more destructive. Our humiliating withdrawal left terrorists with billions of dollars of weapons. Those weapons will be shared among the over 20 U.S.-designated terrorist organizations in the terrorist ecosystem across Afghanistan and Pakistan. Because some of those groups have already turned against the nuclear-armed Pakistani army and government, it is not difficult to imagine terrorists gaining access to the most destructive weapons on Earth. It is for these reasons that I believe our self-defeat in Afghanistan and our broader disengagement from the fight against jihadist terrorists internationally in recent months has made jihadist terrorists more dangerous today than they were on 10 September 2001. Finally, we are already witnessing the political dimension of our lost war. From Tehran to Moscow to Beijing to Pyongyang, our adversaries are emboldened, and our friends and allies doubt that we are trustworthy. Thank you for the privilege of being with you. I believe that this committee's oversight role may be more important than ever because the humanitarian, security, and political disaster in Afghanistan is the result of incompetence across multiple administrations. Unless the American people and their representatives in Congress demand better from our leaders, the prospect of learning from our searing experience in South Asia, rebuilding our strategic competence, and effacing the stain of 2021 will remain dim. Thank you.